What's up, guys? Airrick here, and in today's video, we have a couple things I want to talk about. Actually, a few things I want to talk about. We're going to talk about a recasting, possible recasting for the Superman and Lois series. I'm going to talk a little bit about their filming schedule and how things are affecting me and how I think it's going to affect them, as well as we have the dates and times now for the Crisis on Infinite Earths re-airing on the CW. As you guys know, if you saw my video from yesterday, they are taking a few shows and putting them on hiatus for the next 2 or 3 weeks. And so we're gonna be getting a re-airing of that Crisis event, and it's gonna take place over the course of the middle of 1 week, over I think 3 nights, but we'll look at that in a minute and check that out. The first thing I wanna talk about, well, before I get into this, how is everyone doing? How are you doing? How are you handling things? May I suggest some things to help you pass your time? Reading digital comics is a really good way to pass time. Personally, the three apps that I use is the DC Universe app, great for the DC comics. Marvel Unlimited is okay, it's not the best. And Comixology, which if you have Amazon, you can just get that as an additional service. And they have tons of books you can borrow from their library and read, help you pass the time, as well as binging a bunch of stuff. Hopefully you guys are doing that. I'm binging shows that I've never seen before. I think I'm gonna go back and watch Lucifer. I've never watched that series, so a lot of people have suggested for me to go back and watch it, so I'm excited about doing that. So I'm gonna go back and watch Lucifer. So hopefully you guys are staying safe and this will pass very soon, I hope. I know we have a long way to go still, but hopefully we get through it together and we're better off on the other side of this, and that everyone makes it through safe. That's my wishes, I hope. I know it's like a utopian mindset, but hopefully that's the case. So let's talk a little bit about this Superman and Lois recasting. Now, don't worry, I don't think it's a major character, but if you did watch season one of Supergirl, it's going to be a character that you guys may recognize. It says, the CW's upcoming Superman and Lois TV series is set to recast another major character from the pages of DC. And I think that's sort of them sort of hyping it up a little bit. Another major character from DC Comics is set to appear on Superman and Lois as the series is allegedly recasting Lois Lane's father, General Sam Lane, who was last seen in the first season of Supergirl as a recurring antagonist with a hatred of aliens. Now, if you guys don't remember, this is the actor who played Sam Lane as General Morshauer, or Glenn, General, Glenn Morshauer, I believe is how you pronounce his last name. Now, I don't know a lot about him, but this guy is in like everything military. If you've seen something military-based, he has been in so many things in that genre of film and TV show. So I'm sure you've seen him somewhere if you did not see the first season of Supergirl. He's a very recognizable actor, but this is the character they're looking to recast, and he was Sam Lane in season one of Supergirl. So again, not a huge character, but a pretty big, I guess a big deal in terms of like the lore of Supergirl, but we are on Earth Prime, and maybe that's gonna be the explanation for why he looks different, or he may not ever interact with anyone on Supergirl once he's on Superman and Lois, which would mean that we would never have one of those awkward moments where he has to talk about the fact that he does not look the same. But so that's the recasting. It goes, according to character descriptions and the Illuminati, the show is looking for a Caucasian male in his 60s to play the character who will be a series regular. So he's not just a recurring character. General Sam Lane is going to be a character who's going to be in most of the season. So that's what it means by recurring. So we're going to see him quite a bit, we're going to see him quite a bit on the show. The character is described as a serious army general whose main mission is to protect the United States of America as well as the world from any threats, whether it comes from on or off Earth. The description also states that anyone working under or together with Lane is expected to perform at 110% no matter what. So my only issue with this is I thought the whole idea of this alien situation on Earth being this big threat, I think we've already covered that. That was a story that we already did in Supergirl. I really hope, this is my hope, please don't make it so we're gonna rehash and go through the beats of that story with General Lane over on Superman and Lois, because I personally do not wanna see more of that. I want them to just sort of, I'd rather them just do their own thing. And just the idea of him being against aliens and stuff, we've already done that story. It goes, played by Glenn Morshauer on Supergirl. The last time Lane physically appeared in the series was the season one finale, Better Angels, with his final scene having him give the Omega Hydron to Maxwell Lord, who also has been missing since season one, in the episode's closing minutes. What this was setting up was never explored when the series moved from the CBS to the CW. However, as character breakdowns and a synopsis for the pilot script provided with Primetimer states that Lane knows about Clark's dual identity and is even willing to call him in for help. Lane may have changed his views over the years So it says here, Lane isn't the only Supergirl character to make a return, as the pilot script also seemingly features the return of Morgan Edge, though whether this time is the same character and actor seen on the former show is unknown. So that is the recasting that we're probably going to get. Morgan Edge may get recasted. We're not sure yet. Maxwell Lord, where are you? Where's the Omega Hydran? We haven't seen that storyline with Maxwell Lord in forever. So it looks like that's going to be the recasting. So if you were emotionally attached to the original Sam Lane from Supergirl season one, just be prepared that he's not going to be the same character. So I don't know anybody that was. But yes, the actor who played him was very recognizable. So there you go. There's the news on that. Let's move over to the news or the story here. This was the last bit of production info I think we got for Superman and Lois. It says, after quite a bit of speculation, KryptonSide has learned that Lee Tolland Krieger, who helmed the pilot episode of Riverdale, will be the director for the first upcoming Superman and Lois TV series, the pilot episode with Elizabeth Tulloch, Tyler Hoechlin, Jordan Eless, and Alexander Garfin. Additionally, Vancouver production charts list quite a window for the production office to be open. It is said to start on March 23rd, which it did not, and continue on to May 14th, right before the upfronts. Going to be a move that more than one episode will be shooting before that time. Well, we don't know. It could be just in time the production office will begin to will be open. So that was like the production window, March 23rd to May 14th. Now, I'm just going to talk from my perspective where I am. Right now, pretty much everything, regardless of what happens, is shut down until May 1st. The entire month of April, probably not much is going to happen here, and I'm pretty sure that in other places that have similar situations in terms of the way they're doing their quarantining and things are going to be working the same way, which means that this show, as far as I can tell right now, has no new date to film. So March 23rd to March 14th was the filming date. Obviously not going to happen. I really hope we get some news and updates on the show, because at the way this looks now, if it has to start filming at a later date, it'll probably premiere at a later date. It only makes sense. So the show may get a shorter season. All of our CW shows may premiere during the mid-season instead of at the beginning of the fall season, which would be catastrophic, I think, for the CW, for all their shows to be hit like that. So we're going to have to wait and see how that goes. But yeah, it looks like those dates are just not, definitely not going to happen. Let's talk a little bit about the crisis stuff here. So this is over on TV Line, and I will link, I'll try and link all the articles I can in the info box, as I usually do, so you guys can go back and read it for yourself. It says, the CW to Arrow crisis crossover among other reruns in place of new episodes. It says here, the CW is using one crisis to solve another. Great, great line there. As the network adjusts to the inducing scheduling changes, you know, the illness, and suspended productions, the Arrowverse Crisis on Infinite Earth crossover will be among the reruns aired in early April instead of new episodes. The network previously aired a Legends of Tomorrow repeat instead of a first-run episode on March 24th, and fresh installments of both The Flash and Legends will be replaced by repeats on Tuesday, March 31st, now announced by the CW on Thursday. The week of April 5th will also rely on reruns, including all five parts of the Crosses crossover, previously aired hours of and the previously aired hours of Batwoman and Supergirl. So, some of the other shows are coming back as normal, but here's going to be, this is going to be the rerun schedule if you didn't get a chance to see all the episodes or if you just want to watch them again. So, on Sunday, April 5th, we're going to get a rerun of Batwoman and Supergirl. I'm not sure which episodes it's going to be. I assume it's going to be probably the latest episodes, just reran again. And then on Tuesday, April 7th, in place of The Flash and Legends, we're going to get Crisis on Infinite Earths Part 1 and Crisis on Infinite Earths Part 2. On Wednesday, we're going to get one installment and then a new Nancy Drew. It's going to be Crisis on Infinite Earths Part 3. Then on Thursday, April 9th, we will get the continuation and finale of the event with Crisis Part 4 and Crisis Part 5 at 8 and 9 p.m. respectively. So if you have the CW, that is Eastern time, by the way. If you have the CW or you're able to access the CW, those are the times you're going to be able to watch it live as it airs, opposed to watching it on playback in case you haven't had time or you don't have access to those episodes on playback. So I, you know, during my live stream, I said this was a possibility. I thought for sure Crisis is a great way to just sort of put it out again, get some really high ratings off of this playback for this event, and also save an entire week of having to deal with new Arrowverse shows. So I made a video where I talked about the other shows being basically offline indefinitely, not coming back. April 7th was the date that we were supposed to get a new Flash and Legends. That got pushed back, obviously. So it's quite possible that the next week after this, on the 14th of that week, we're going to see the new episodes return for the shows. It is quite possible. However, I am, like I said in that other video, this is a minute by minute thing. We're not sure how things are going to change, but I'm just glad that we got the official scheduling for this now. We know when it's going to come back. So that's pretty much it. There isn't much else to talk about in this video. I kind of wanted to stay focused on these three things. So we know we're getting a Sam Lane recasting in the Arrowverse over on the Superman and Lois show. Who it's going to be, we don't know. We're probably going to get a Morgan Edge recasting. Maybe Maxwell Lord will come back, but we'd have to recast him as well, I suppose. But all that could be over the Superman and Lois show whenever it starts to air, whenever that show comes back to film. So we don't know when they're going to film. Hopefully very soon. And then the crisis changes, obviously. So let me know down in the comments below your thoughts on any and all of this. Are you worried about the scheduling conflicts here with the shutdown of everything? Is it something that's going to be bothering you? And how do you think they're going to wrap this up and get the shows back on track for next season? Also, are you going to be watching Crisis live again when it airs? Or have you already watched it on playback two or three times? I've watched it more than once already, but I'll probably watch it again when it airs just because. And we'll probably do an after party that week, maybe after all five parts air. Revisit it, talk about it again, and sort of those kinds of things. I'll think about it, maybe adjusting my after party for this event since it does end on a Thursday night. Here's the thing, guys, you have to subscribe to my channel. If you're new to the Airrickverse, please hit the subscribe button, become part of this amazing community of people. You guys are super supportive, and thank you so much for always being there and being a part of the conversation. If you want to support in another way, you can go ahead and hit that join button and become part of Team Airrick. Right now, there are three bonus videos. There's two exclusives, one early access, as well as some behind the scenes videos. Why am I getting so tongue-tied? You can see my review for Watchmen season one. You can check out my review of Birds of Prey. You can also get early access for another few days for the Black Lightning season three overview before it comes out over the weekend. But when that goes out live, my Arrow season eight overview will go on early access on Team Airrick. So if you want to get all that early, hit the join button. I understand if you can't, times are hard. And if not, you will see it on my regular channel eventually. And if you can't do it, I totally get it. I totally understand. I have new merch coming out. Keep an eye on that. It will debut at the beginning of April. And give me a like if you enjoyed this video. Why did I save till the end to say give me a like? Because most people are not watching this far. We're going to play a game. If you watch this video all the way till the end, in the comments section, tell me what your favorite pizza is, because pizza is my favorite food. So if you give me like, tell me what your favorite pizza is in the comment section below, you won't win a prize, but I'll know that you made it all the way through to the end. That's pretty much it. And I'll catch you guys in the next video. Have a great week.